Hi everyone, my name is Adam McIntosh from WebSAN Solutions, and today I'm going to be taking you through our artificial intelligence forecasting within our sales and operations planning app for Dynamics Business Central. So just before we get started, I wanted to talk a little bit about WebSAN. We're a Microsoft Gold certified partner with offices in Toronto as well as the US. We've been in the Microsoft Dynamics space for 22, 23 years now. And right now we focus really on that SMB client, mainly using Microsoft Dynamics Business Central, but along with other ancillary products. So what I want to talk to you about today is our AI generated forecasting within our sales and operations planning app. Now, this feature allows you to generate a sales forecast or a sales budget within Business Central using literally a single click. What we've done is we've synchronized your historical sales data by item, by customer, by date, by location into a historical table that will synchronize with Azure. And what that allows us to do is train our data model and our machine learning model with your own data. So each customer has their own data that is used to train that model, which is actually really crucial because it allows us to give you a good forecast with your data. So from there, Business Central handles the rest. It will push and pull the data between Azure and Business Central and allow you to get that single click forecast whenever you need it. Okay. So obviously using an AI generated forecast helps to improve your forecasting process. It eliminates human subjectivity and bias from the process, allowing you to leverage those AI resources that are now in the marketplace and gives you insights that, quite frankly, you might not have otherwise had just using your own manual methods. That better forecast is going to bleed into other parts of your business because now you're going to be making better decisions based on better data. So you're going to avoid understocking, avoid overstocking, and hopefully get optimal inventory levels based on an accurate sales forecast. And again, this whole process is quite frankly accessible. So you don't need special programming or quantitative skills in order to generate that forecast. We've built that machine learning model for you and we've implemented it within Azure and Business Central. Now, the exact architecture we used, I've tried to outline a little bit here. What we do is we take your historical sales data, as I mentioned, synchronize that to Azure. That then feeds the data into our machine learning models. And that machine learning model performs the necessary analysis in order to push forecasted data back into Business Central. And we put that into staging tables within Business Central. And then our sales and operations planning app can pull that data into the sales budget window within Business Central. So now that we've talked about it, let's jump into Business Central and take a look.
All right, so here I am in Business Central, and the first thing I want to talk to is our sales and operations planning setup window. So if I go into that window, one of the current features we have is that you can synchronize your actual sales to that historical sales data table. But what we've added is we've added the feature to sync that table as well to Azure. And then when you synchronize that data to Azure, that's where it's going to help train the model. And that's where we can start using some of this data. Now, if I want to jump into that historical sales data table, just to quickly look at some of the entries, I like to do that at the beginning. And you can actually see here, if I sort this, we're only dealing with five items here, and I'll show you those five items, but we've got almost 6,800 entries. So we do need quite a bit of data in here in order to get realistic results. And I've actually put this into a pivot table. And you can see here, there's a little bit of seasonality in some of these items. So the first few items here, you can see we sell quite a bit more, roughly around kind of 200,000 in the first 3 months of the year. And then it dips later on in the year. And you can even see here, it goes down quite a bit to about 25,000 in the summer months. So we've got some seasonality and we should see that in some of our results. I've highlighted this other item here, and here's my items I'm dealing with. These first five. this other item right here. I've highlighted it red because while we do have quite a bit of data for it, we have 3 years worth of data for it. It's a little bit sporadic in that sales have fluctuated quite dramatically. 1 month we only had 33 units sold, whereas in recent months it's a little bit more. So this one, a little bit more difficult to predict. We'll still get results, but we have to expect that those results won't necessarily be as accurate. And that's where I spoke to earlier, garbage in, garbage out. If you don't have high quality data, you're not going to be able to expect the model to give you a high quality prediction. You'll still get something, but it'll be less accurate. So let's go dive into our sales budget in Dynamics. So here's our sales budget. I'm going to be dealing with my 2024 budget. Let's click edit. And if I set up my settings here, I want to view this by month. That should be good. And I'm just going to deal with these five items, same five items I showed in that screenshot before. And let's just do it for 2024. Perfect. So here's my 2024 budget right now. I've got nothing. And I can scroll through here. You can see I don't have any sort of budget loaded. So let's use our existing functionality where we apply the historical projection. Just get a quick reminder of how that works. Oh, I think I had data back to October 2019 there. And if I go all the way to September of this year, that should give us a good range of data. And we can apply that in. So that'll take 20 seconds here just to think through all the different computations and load the data in. So this is our existing feature. And what you'll see here is it's a straight line, average projection, no seasonality, nothing special about this. It's just taking your current average historical sales and applying that to the existing items. Now, what we want to show or what we've added to the system is this apply AI projection. So if I click that, you can see here we've got some additional features. So admittedly, this process does take a while. In fact, it can take up to about 10 minutes or so. So through the power of video editing here, I'm just going to cut this section out. And once this is complete, we'll jump back into the system. That said, that 10 minute gap, that will allow up to millions of records. I think we've tested with about 12 million or so records at this time, and we're continuing to expand upon that. So right now, we're going to take a quick break and I'll come back once this is complete. All right, with the power of editing, we're back and the AI forecast has been generated from Azure. In this window, you'll actually see a button here. It says view forecasted values. So you can actually preview what's going to be loaded into the sales budget before it's actually loaded. But if you want to apply those values into your sales budget, you click apply forecast values. It's going to go through. Obviously, it's got to take a second or two to load those values. Same way it did the historical projection. All right, and there you go. We've actually loaded our values in there. And you can actually see a little bit of seasonality here in those first 3 months for that first item where it's a little bit higher and then it dips down. Now it's, I think the data we were looking at previously was 2021. So this data is a little bit lower. It's trending on the lower side in recent months, but you can say definitely see a little bit of seasonality where things trend downwards in certain months and higher in other months. So that was our video for you today. We'd love to work with you on implementation, and I'm going to quickly wrap up here.
All right. Thanks, everyone, for your time today. Really appreciate you taking a look at our new feature. If you are interested in our application, please feel free to reach out to our team at info@websand.com. And a reminder to like this video and follow us on YouTube for more great Business Central content. Thanks, everyone.